الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل
وكل في فلك يسبحون
ويخلق ما لا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now we are still talking about the chapter of Al-Insan, and before talking we are in the third of the month of Ramadan, about which the Prophet ﷺ, he said the beginning of Ramadan, the first 10 days are rahmah and the second 10 days are forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are in need for such forgiveness. We are in need for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our past sins, and we ask Him to protect us against committing any sins in the future, inshaAllah. The majority of the verses in Surah Al-Insan in general are talking about the blessings and pleasures of paradise, as we said before. And before, we talked about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the righteous people. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُرًا. And then he said, وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا, because of their patience, because they were patient with desires and they prevented themselves from many things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them blessings and pleasures that we talked before about paradise. And today we still have the same very, very nice talking about the pleasures and the blessings of paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here says in chapter Al-Insan, verse number 19, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْدَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ إِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ حَسِبْتَهُمْ لُؤْلُؤًا مَنْثُورًا. So another blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give to the people of paradise, because as we said before, they have suffered in this life, they prevented themselves from many pleasures, so it's very just by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them a kind of reward, to give them a kind of compensation. Because those people who enjoy themselves very well here, they might be prevented from the pleasures in the hereafter. And those who suffered here, they will have a kind of blessings and a kind of pleasure in the next life, inshaAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here confirms another pleasure that He will give to the people of paradise. And He said, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْدَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ, and round about them will serve youth of perpetual or eternal youth. So they are not like young, for example, boys in this life, in the dunya, but they are مُخَلَّدُونَ. Exegetes or مُفَسِّرُون differed about the word مُخَلَّدُونَ. Some of them said that they will be always like that. Some others said that their colors and their faces will never be changed. They will be in an eternal position, I mean their appearance and so on. And the same verse was repeated in different surahs with different meanings. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, is saying in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, وَيَطُوفَ عَلَيْهِمْ غِلْمَانُ لَهُمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونَ, and round them servants or boys will serve them, and they are like well-kept pearl. So their color or their faces or their appearance is exactly not white, not black, not like for example the young boys here in this life, but they are like pearl, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْغِلْمَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ, and they will never be changed. And in another surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah At-Tur, He says, وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ غِلْمَانُ لَهُمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونَ. So although the verse or the meaning has been mentioned with different contexts, but it has the same connotation and it gives the same idea about Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu wardahuma. He said that every one of the people of paradise will be given around 1,000 young boys just to serve him. So again, remember all these pleasures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you remember these pleasures and compare them to the very limited and the useless pleasures of this life, you will know, of course, the big difference. And as we mentioned many verses before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَمْتَعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدِّنَّا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا قَلِينَ. The pleasures in this life compared to the hereafter are very limited, and they are not eternal as those in the hereafter. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that this life is the dunya is exactly like a bridge. Or like, for example, if you are cultivating here, and then you will get the fruits, you will reap the fruits over there. So if you cultivate here in a very good way, then you will have a good, for example, harvest. But if you didn't cultivate here, you will have no harvest. It's very simple. If you work hard in a company, for example, you are going to get a very good reward by your manager, by your company, by your organization. But let us imagine that somebody, for example, is a lazy employee. He either is going to be fired and he will get no payment at all because he is not working hard. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to do the same thing. For the righteous people, they will be rewarded by him. And for those who were not righteous, who didn't strive hard, who didn't, for example, serve or worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be, then there will be another way of dealing with them. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا رَأَيْتَهُمْ حَسِبْتَهُمْ لُؤْلُؤًا مَنْثُورًا. If you look at them, exactly they look like pearl, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying here. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, many verses in the Quran are talking about, for example, the pleasures of paradise. Another verse in chapter of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just depicting or portraying how does paradise look like. The verse says in Arabic, مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ فِيهَا أَنْهَارٌ مِنْ مَاءٍ غَيْرَ آسٍ وَأَنْهَارٌ مِنْ لَبَنٍ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ وَأَنْهَارٌ مِنْ خَمْرٍ لَذَّةٍ لِلشَّارِبِينَ وَأَنْهَارٌ مِنْ عَسَلٍ مُصَفًّى وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ. So the example of paradise, which is going to be prepared for the righteous, for the good believers. What has been prepared for the people of paradise are different rivers, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ فِيهَا أَنْهَارٌ مِنْ مَاءٍ غَيْرَ آسٍ. Rivers of water that has not been changed, water that has not been contaminated by anything, has not been defiled, as the water we have, for example, in this life, it might be defiled or contaminated by anything. And then, وَنْهَارٌ مِنْ لَبَنٍ لَمْ يَتَغَيَّرْ طَعْمُهُ. Rivers of milk, that also the taste of which, the color, the smell, have not been changed. And then, وَنْهَارٌ مِنْ عَسَلٍ مُصَفَّى. And then they will also be provided with rivers of very, very refined honey that has nothing bad at all. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after that he says, وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ. They will have all different kinds of fruits. As I said before, and as we stated before, fruits will not be, for example, cut off. If you are now, if you are in summer, you can't find, for example, the fruits of winter. And if you are in winter, you can't find fruits of summer. But in the hereafter in Jannah, all these things are available. Just as we have been told by different traditions, you just imagine something and then you'll have it. You don't, for example, need to go for shopping or go to the market and pay the money. No, nothing like that at all. All you need there is just, for example, as the hadith says, when you see a bird, for example, and you wish that you would eat this bird, you will find it in front of you ready to be eaten. And the same thing like fruits. If you just think about something, you will find it. Because this is, again, as we stated, if you are inviting people, you are doing your best to make this invitation very good. You will do your best to prepare everything, foods, drinks, vegetables, fruits, everything. And you will think about if you have missed anything, to make just the banquet or the invitation looks excellent. This is what a human being has prepared. So how about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all universe, has prepared for the righteous and for the believers? So after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ رَأَيْتَ نَعِيمًا وَمُلْكًا كَبِيرًا. And when you look, it is there, you will see a bliss and a realm magnificent. This verse reminds me of one report I have read about. SubhanAllah, this is the situation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He can't be compared to any other human being. And if we compare the situation with the Prophet and compare the very, very luxurious life of some rulers, for example, nowadays, they are living in a very luxurious life and they have mansions, palaces, but there is a big difference in the issue of belief between some of them, or between all of them, and between the great Prophet who was given the message by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and who was given the full guidance, and he is going to guide all humanity to paradise. One day, Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he entered upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, And he looked at the Prophet and he found that the Prophet was lying on his side on carpet, which was not very, very good. And he said to the Prophet, "Oh, Messenger of Allah, I remembered your situation. And I imagine the situation of some kings and rulers of Persia and Roman Empire and all these countries. They live very luxurious life. They have mansions, carpets and everything, servants, and you don't have any of these things." And then the Prophet ﷺ, in a very sound belief and in a very authentic way, he said to him, "Didn't you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in chapter of Al-Insan, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ثَمَّ رَأَيْتَ نَعِيمًا وَمُلْكًا كَبِيرًا." The pleasure you have here, palaces, whatever you have here, will come to an end one day. But the pleasure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare for us, for the believers, for the Prophet, for the companions, is something which is unlimited and something that will never come to an end at all. So, always we need to strive hard to get a place there. In our language, to book a ticket in paradise. Instead of booking a ticket, for example, to go travel, pay a lot of money to see one of the views or something, that's fine, there's no problem with that. But always, as long as we remember this life, we remember to enjoy ourselves, but with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts, remember the eternal enjoyment and the eternal pleasure that you will have in the hereafter. If you only you need two conditions, if you stick to the Quran and if you stick to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was reported that the Prophet ﷺ told one of the companions who said to him, "O Messenger of Allah, tell me about one of the deeds that will take me to paradise and keep me away from hellfire." And then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "You have asked about something which is great, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for those who try to get closer to Him." The first thing, if you want to go to paradise, you need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray, do fasting and go for hajj and pay zakah. Normally, you have to perform the five pillars of Islam. And another companion came to him and said, "O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I want to go to paradise and the Islamic obligations are so many, what should I do?" The Prophet said to him, "Stick to the five pillars of Islam and don't add anything else." And then the man said, "And then I'll enter paradise." The Prophet ﷺ said to him, "You will enter paradise." And also it was reported that Sayyidina Ibrahim ﷺ said to the Prophet was told that Sayyidina Ibrahim said, "O Muhammad, tell your nation about paradise and tell them that it is great and its smell is marvelous. So get prepared for it." And one example, if you want to travel to a country, you need to pack everything, prepare everything, tickets, food, money, clothes, and all these things. Before leaving, before going to the airport, you have to make sure that you have got everything. So this is just a travel that might take one day, a week, month, year, and so on. And at the end, you must come home. But remember, a journey that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how long it will take. And if you have the good provision with you, you are prepared with the Quran, prayers and good deeds, then there is no worry at all. But if you didn't prepare yourself, then you might be in trouble and you might need to check your situation before meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because as we are told, the Prophet ﷺ said, "The one who likes to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah also likes to meet him." So, but how can we meet him? Is it in our situation now, we are a little bit disobedient, we are not performing prayers on time, we are not, for example, performing Islam as it should be, but this case must be changed. We need to make a kind of change to the best, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah Al-Anfal, "Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi-anfusihim." Allah cannot or will not change the situation of people unless they have the intention to do that.
Back to the Prophet. Join Sheikh Amar in the program Back to the Prophet, wherein he teaches us practical lessons from the Prophet's life and how this can help us to overcome our challenges in the present.
We talk about the life example of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, seeking guidance for ourselves. In the early days after the revelation of the Holy Quran, the Muslims were greatly persecuted, so much so that quite a few Muslims had to leave Arabia and migrate to Africa to live among Ahl Kitab, Christian people who followed the Gospel of Christ.
O Allah, give me repentance or show me the way for repentance. And then you need to work hard to do that, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Tahrim is saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, tubu ilallahi tawbatan nasuha. O you who believe, make a sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not, as we said before, some people are ridiculing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they say, okay, they do a sin, and then they say, okay, I repent, and then they do it again, and then they say, I repent. This is not, it's something serious. If you want to do that, you need, of course, to have sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to be accepted. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ عَمَلُوا السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ فَأُولَئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. So, repentance, those who do a sin by mistake, they are not willing to do it, for example, and then they seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincere repentance, and He will also accept their repentance and guide them to the right path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here also, He says in verse number 23, 21, عَلَيْهُمْ ثِيَابُ سُنْدُسٍ خُضْرٌ وَاسْتَبْرَقٌ وَحُلُّوا أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا طَهُورًا. So another pleasure that is given to the people of paradise, Allah is saying here, upon them will be green garments of the fine or pure silk and heavy brocade, and they will be adorned. وَحُلُّوا أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ. They will be adorned or decorated by bracelets which are made of silver. And in another verse, silvers or bracelets are made out of gold. As we said yesterday, that what is prohibited here will no longer be prohibited in paradise. For example, silk or wearing silk was forbidden to the ummah in this life, but in the hereafter it will be made available by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also wearing or using gold is prohibited here. It will be made available in the hereafter by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on. Because Jannah is the place in which you will have a kind of rest. You are not going to pray there. You are not going to pay zakah or do anything, or, for example, go for jihad. No, because you have done all these things in your previous life, then here you have just to rest, and just even the language of people there, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا تأثيما إلا قيلا سلاما سلاما. They will not listen to idle talks or foolish words, or, for example, a kind of offense. No, all these things will be taken from their hearts before they enter paradise. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍ. We have taken out everything which is bad from their hearts. So they will enter paradise with clean hearts. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. And then they will sit on something like cushions and close to each other. And after that, they will enter paradise, as the Quran stated. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here says, وَحُلُّوا أَسَاوِرَ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ. So, and in Surah Al-Hajj, Allah is saying, وَلِبَاسُهُمْ فِيهَا حَرِيرٌ. Their clothes or their dress will be made out of very fine and very pure silk. They will be, given many pleasures and given many blessings by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because, as we stated, this is the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the source of all generosity, and there is no generous better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He gives and He doesn't wait for anything in return, but human beings give and they are waiting for their turn. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after that, He says, وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا طَهُورًا. Subhanallah, what kind of greatness and what kind of blessings will they will have. وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ, they will given by their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a kind of drink, which is very pure, and they have never drank before something like that, because this has been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, for example, we might be astonished by a kind of, for example, organic juice or juice that was, for example, was made in one of the countries. And we feel very amazed about it. We think that it's, for example, marvelous, great, magnificent, and this is what, as I said before, what a human being has prepared. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare can never be imitated and has no equal, because this is what He will provide the righteous and provide the believers. So all these things are, you could say, to urge Muslims to work hard, to urge Muslims to think deeply about the hereafter, because most of us, we are busy with our life, we are busy with our business, bank accounts, money, cars, children, academic degrees and PhD, MA, all these things. That's fine, you can think about them, but don't forget the hereafter. As one of the sayings, which for example, state that if you need to work for the hereafter, as if you are going to die tomorrow, and work for the dunya as you are going to live forever. So the Sahaba, the companions, they prepared themselves for the hereafter much, much better than their preparedness for this dunya and for this very limited and very short life. Great examples like Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, the rightly guided caliphs and the successors and all of them, they strived hard to get the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to get a place in paradise in the hereafter. So, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, we have the best example in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who left us with the right guidance that if you stick to, you will never go astray. So we need to take the Prophet as the example and read the story, the biography of the companions and rightly guided caliphs, because they are the best people after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these are just part of the pleasures that have been prepared, and inshallah next time we are going to give more details about that at the end. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our good deeds and to forgive all our sins until we meet again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب صنع الله الذي أتقن كل شيء إنه خبير بما تفعلون
مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل
وكل في فلك يسبحون
ويخلق